Now, here are some ways you can incorporate appropriate body language into your speeches. Eye contact. Have you ever conversed with someone who did not look at you directly? The person looked over your shoulder, above your head, at the floor, at their phone, or even at someone else, everywhere but you. How does that make you feel? Most likely, you doubted that person's interest, honesty, and confidence. Or you may have felt excluded or ignored. The truth is, eye contact plays a major role in how people perceive one another. And as a speaker, you must pay special attention to it. Establishing eye contact with your audience is a prerequisite for being able to project and create a bond with your audience. Don't just pass your gaze throughout the room. Instead, try to focus on individual listeners and construct a bond with them by looking at them directly in the eye for 5 to 10 seconds. To make this happen a little easier, find a single person in the audience. You know, those who are nodding in agreement or fully engaged with your every word. And make eye contact with him or her. Stay with that person long enough to deliver a full sentence or complete thought. Gestures. Gestures are the most expressive part of body language and consist of movements of the head, shoulders, arms, hands, or some other part of the body. To be most effective, gestures should be made above your elbow and away from your body. And they can be vigorous and definite to show conviction and enthusiasm. For example, a sweeping wave of your arm to show distance, or a rapid up and down nod of your head to indicate approval will add more of a punch to your message than a half-hearted hand wave or a barely noticeable dip of the head. Facial expression. Your face conveys how your listeners are supposed to react and feel. For example, if you're talking about a terrible automotive accident, yet you are smiling and nodding, your audience will be confused, not sad. Your facial expression must be consistent with the feelings or information you are communicating. Your eyes, eye movement, eyebrows, and mouth play vital roles in showing sadness, fear, happiness, anger, frustration, nervousness, excitement, boredom, interest, wonder, exhaustion, aggressiveness, confidence, and uncertainty. Whenever you show these feelings, your audience will imitate them. Show sadness by lowering your eyelids, turning down your mouth slightly, and bowing your head. Show surprise and disbelief by widening your eyes and raising your eyebrows. Smile broadly to show happiness. Make it natural. Body language needs to look natural so that it is consistent with the meaning of the words spoken. Using body language that is comfortable for you and enjoyable for the audience takes thought and practice. It is so important to practice your speech in front of a mirror, camera, or in front of a few trusted friends or family so that your eye contact, gestures, and facial expressions fit appropriately into your speech. Match your gestures to your words. You should be compelled to gesture and make facial expressions when your thought requires such action.